Hey, what's going on? Bacon day! Woo! Who doesn't love bacon? So let's get a lesson in bacon. Here we have two forms of side bacon and back bacon, or pea meal bacon. They don't actually roll it in pea meal, they use cornmeal these days. Side bacon. Not brined, not smoked, fresh. Canadian pork, nice. Side bacon, cured and smoked. Back bacon, cured, not smoked, rolled in cornmeal. And guess what? These are all from Canada. They're all Canadian bacon. Back bacon is what we're gonna do today. I did a back bacon video a while back with pineapple and maple syrup. Today it's just going to be apple juice. All right, we'll get a bit set up. Hold on. Okay, we have a new addition to the party. Another chunk of back bacon taken out of the package. It was on sale this week. These were $6 each, 2 pounds. 1¾, almost 2 pounds, 800 grams. So I'm going to inject this with some apple juice and put it in a Ziploc and put it in the fridge overnight. And we'll do it tomorrow. So let me put all this other stuff in the fridge, my nice collection of bacon. And saw this in the No Frills the other day, 30% off. All right. Got in the mood and I said I'm going to make some of MMT's Libra case. So I saw it on the shelf, said, aha, I need that. I'll be doing that, I don't know, sometime in the future. I'm just going to freeze that. It's too goddamn hot to have the oven on. It'll cool down one of these days. Oh, and I have beer. Beer. Because beer is good. Alrighty, okay, let's get set up. Well, it's pretty basic what we're gonna do. Next time I go to the doctor and have to give a sample, I should bring this in. I don't know what would happen. Okay, just apple juice. You could use like apple cider. I just don't have any around. That is actually really nice. But this is what I got. I'll just dab her any old way. Fill it up. Oh, they got a hole. Well, these things happen. It is the pork loin, you know. And we're going to soak this overnight. And in the morning, well, lunchtime, whenever we do it, we will roll it in for some fresh cornmeal again. All right. Yeah, should have put more in. Anyway, and we will also spritz it with apple juice. Alrighty. Ziploc. Got one of them right here. So yeah, put that in the fridge overnight. Wash your hands. If you want to be clean. If you don't want to be clean, don't wash your hands. What do I care? I like to wash my hands. Or use gloves. Alrighty. Get rid of this crap. And that's that. See you tomorrow. And, oh yeah. Drink on. Woo! And everybody knows that Vault Boy approves of bacon, especially back bacon. Right on. Hey, we're back. Through the magic of time travel, it's tomorrow. and we got euchred. It hasn't rained here in 4 weeks, and everything's set up outside. First time I planned to do a video, it downpoured for 3 minutes, maybe 2.5. Fucked everything up outside. So, outside is just gonna be bare bones. So, here's our back bacon. It's been soaking in the fridge overnight and all day. It was injected with the apple juice. I don't really think we're gonna need to put any extra cornmeal on there. Looks pretty good. Could use a bit there, but doesn't really matter. Here's the other side. Well, put a little bit on there. Alright. Oh, I kicked the thing. Watch out, camera. Oh, I had to make rice because tomorrow I need that rice to be cold. So, actually, the rice that's going in the recipe is already in the fridge. Put a bit of this on here. There. Any places that don't have the cornmeal? There we go. It's alright. A little extra cornmeal never hurt anybody. Unless you have a corn allergy, then, well, your shit'll look. Alright. I'm gonna put this on the spit rod. The charcoal is igniting as we speak. I'm not gonna wash my hands yet because I gotta put this on the spit rod. And, we'll be back when we're ready to put her on. I'm losing light because, well, it's a two cookie day and I took a little bit too long down at the river, and then I was going to bring my camera to the river, but I was too stoned and I forgot the camera here, so I wasn't coming back. But I still do have beer, so woo! Woo! Cornmeal woo. Mm-hmm. All right. We'll get this hooked up, and I had planned to do the whole thing outside. Well, we're going to have to bring her back in once she's done, because this is going to be over an hour at around 3:50, and we'll spritz it with some apple juice as we're going through. Don't worry, you'll see that. All right, rock on. Woo! I said yeah. It's all right. All right. I got the nice little chunk of back bacon on a spit rod, and for cheese, I got some Cracker Barrel Old, and I got some Monterey Jack. So while this beast is spinning on the rotisserie, I'll grate some cheese up so we can have some nice cheese on our bun and our back bacon. I don't have any fancy mustard again. Well, I'm not a big fancy mustard guy. Give me the yellow shit, normal French's. I'm happy. Fancy mustard's expensive, but I got beer. Woo! And it's a two cookie day, and I do have some rice in here, and like, this is cooked nicely. Oh, look. That's delicious. Mmm. Rice. Snack time. Alright. Perfect. Alright. Charcoal is ready to go. I'll go dump it in. And then throw this back bacon on. I'm using my old spit rod and my old motor. It's not the one that came with the Kettle kit. Hey, it still works. It's a motor and it's a spit rod. Why ruin the new one when you have one that still works? Alrighty, we'll be back. Vault Boy approved. Woo! Woo! Here we go. Okay, we're good to go. I just have one charcoal rack. off to the side here. I've got a drip pan in there. I'll show you once I'm done explaining this. I put a little bit of extra cornmeal on the back bacon. Didn't need it, but why not? I got the vent set to about 350, so this should be about an hour and 15 minutes. Maybe an hour and 20, but, you know, rock on, right? This is how we do it. Woo! I'm going to lose light, so I got to do the back half of this inside. Shit happens. One of them things. And it's a two-cookie day, so, you know, this is the way we do it in Utopia. Because I actually do live in Utopia. There you go. All right. And I'm using briquettes. Got some apple juice in the spritzer. Not going to spray it yet. We'll let it get going for a bit, and we'll be back. All righty. Where's my lid? Here's my lid. All righty. We'll be back in about 20 minutes and see what's happening. Alrighty. And drink up, buttercup. Woo! Hey, I shouldn't have covered it up, because I did say I was going to show what's going on inside. So, this is my old rotisserie motor and my old spit rod. Like I said, why use the new one? This one works. So, there's our chunk of back bacon. I got a drip pan with water. And I'm only using briquettes on one side. Don't need it on two sides. You really don't. Like I said, I got the vents already set. So, I got to put that bad boy back on. Listen to some more James Brown and rock on. Alright, now we're cooking with charcoal. Should be cooking with gas. Nope. Oh, it smells good. Oh, too much closed. You don't have to do this. But I like to do this. Oh yeah. Okay. Round and round. What goes around comes around. That's what they say anyway. Not supposed to play that song. They don't like it. The YouTube don't like it when you do that. Fuck them. Fuck the YouTube. Alright, well, it's gonna be dark when this is done, so we'll have to do the cutting inside. Sorry. Alright. Take my fat ass and drink some more beer and woo! Oh, we do have beer here. We do have beer. Beer is good. All right, I will come back. It'll be dark. You'll have to suffer, but it's okay. It's worth it. Rock on. I need to go looking for beer. Oh, I've been busy the last couple of days. An able-bodied person could do that in an afternoon. Horrible thing about firewood, kindling. I hate kindling. I've mentioned that before. Well, it is enough for a few weeks. Yeah. The good thing about this, sure it takes a bit of work. Free. Free. Free kindling, free firewood. It's always good wood, but you still have to work a bit. All right. Beer time. And yeah, okay. Another part of the workstation. All right. Free wood is good wood. Rock on. had to move the camera because our light was fading that way, and there's artificial light coming from the floodlight. So this is what happens. Had to get a beer. Beer is good. I think I've mentioned that before. If I didn't, beer is good. Try it. You'll like it. If you don't, go see a doctor. Alright. I don't know. It's been about 10 minutes or so. I don't know what time it is. Because the clock thing is over there. But when you're wasted, you don't give a shit. So you give it a few sprays. Let her turn and spin. Give her a few more. I don't know. Works for me. Should work for you. Make sure you get the ends too, right? Because that's how she goes, eh? Back bacon. Oh, you're going to be on a nice bun too with some cheese. Cheese and mustard. A little bit of mousy turds. No fancy mustard, just French's. Like I said, you want the fancy shit? Go and buy yourself some fancy shit. Okay, we're good to go. Put back the dome. Alright, we'll be back. We still got at least, 45 minutes. It's only been about 20 or 25, I don't know. But just judging by the look of it, we got about 45 minutes, close to an hour, and we're done. Right on. Alright, here's the deal. It's dark. After a while, I will take this off. Okay, there's our thing. It's going good. I have to put this on the ground. I have a confession to make. This is the first time I have done a back bacon chub on a charcoal Weber kettle. So I got doing shit, and after like an hour and 15 minutes I came out and said, oh shit, I gotta check this. And it wasn't coming along as I had hoped, but I added about a dozen more pieces of charcoal briquette. When I do this again, I will use both baskets. And then I opened up the top vent all the way. And after that, I spritzed it every 10 minutes with the apple juice. And it's coming along beautifully now. So after an hour and 15 with nothing, this is another hour. And we're ready to bring it inside and slice it up, and then we're going to bring it back and melt the cheese and brown the buns. Alright, well, that's what's going on at the moment, and it smells pretty good and it looks pretty good. Alrighty, rock on. Well, here we are inside. We're going to cut this puppy open. Oh, and we still do have beer. Woo! And Mr. Heavy Metal Barbecue. Oh, what is that? Look at what I found. And it's green. Green is good. It's not orange. Orange is the best. If they made it in orange, I would have it. But look at this. I got this for $10. And, you know, I know yours is almond in color, but hey, it works, my friend. Oh yeah. So let's try this out. Oh dear. Oh, look at that. Oh. Thank you.
Oh yeah.
Oh, that one's a little thicker than I wanted, but that's all right. Nice. Oh, look at that, eh? Who knew? Mr. Heavy Metal Barbecue, you've got a big influence here, brother. Oh, yeah. Hamilton Beach. There you go. Nice. All right. What's up with that bullshit? Let's get this done. We're going to put a few pieces on some foil with some cheese, and we're going to rock on. We'll be back. Okay. So I got a few slices here. I have some cheese on there. I got a bun ready to toast. And, yeah, look, here we go. Yummy. Oh, yeah. That's nice. Oh, here, look at that crispy critter. That's good. Come here. Oh, yeah. Okay. So we're good to go. Apple juice? Crazy on there. All right, let's clean off our fingers, and we'll be back. Let's go melt some cheese. All right, we'll be back. Rock on. Oh, and beer on, too. Woo! This beer is good. It's getting late. All right, here we go. Melted some cheese on top of the bacon. Bun is toasted. Got a bit of butter on there. You know, butter is good. We'll put some mustard on top of this. Okay, what's that? Oh, here we go. Come here, you. Do that. Where's the bottom? Hopefully that's the bottom. It is. That's the bottom. Perfect. Look at that. One layer. Uh-oh. It's falling apart. It's, you know. It's done, basically. That's what I'm getting at. Oh, look at that. Extra cheese on there. There you go. There we go. Thank you very much. Come over here, big shooter. We need some mustard on that, I think. Before we need some mustard, we need some beer. Woo! Apple flavored back bacon on the bun. Gotta like it. If you have some fancy mustard, throw some fancy mustard on this. I don't. It's got the old French's, and that's okay with me. Fancy mustard's expensive. I don't have a lot of money. All right. Now, should we cut this bitch in half? Sure, why not? Look at that, eh? Do we have a knife? Yes, we do. Knife is good. Here we go. Okay. Yahoo! Here we go. Look at that. Oh, that looks so good. Back bacon on a bun with a bit of cheese and some mustard. Oh yeah. On the GBS. Oh, fuck. That's fucking good. Oh, hello. Well. Good thing I wasn't in a rush for this. Because holy shit. That's fucking dynamite. Well, I really recommend that you try this out. Wow. Remember, back bacon is not called Canadian bacon. It's fucking back bacon. There you go. Look at that. Oh, back bacon on a bun. You get a good back bacon on a bun at the X, the CNE. Now, I haven't been there in about 15 years, but you still get a good back bacon on a bun there, guaranteed. But you get a better one here. So come and see me. You want to come for a visit? I'm in. Let's visit. Woo! All right. Oh, give me a beer. Beer is good. I like beer. All right. Well, there we go. That's our lesson for today, kiddies. Fuck yeah. Absolutely. Try this shit out, man. Okay. Till next time. Rock on! Woo!